Good evening and welcome to ATV News. My name is Shalom Lawson. On tonight's bulletin, Harare is hit by water shortages and a risk of typhoid outbreak. Breast cancer survivors speak out. Chip cane spirits flood Bulawayo. And Highlanders coach Ali Baba Dube goes down memory lane. Persistent water shortages are causing headaches for Harare residents amid reports of a typhoid outbreak in the capital and in Chitungwiza. Jeffrey Moyo reports.
Some suburbs in Harare have gone for weeks without water, sparking fears of a fresh outbreak of cholera and typhoid. Harare City Council has also intensified water rationing, a move that has seriously affected residents in the city. ATV spoke to some of the affected residents who said the situation was critical.
Parizvino, tikangoti papa nesvondo, payanga chinetsa mvura kubva kuseni every morning. Yozoya zvayo kana manheru kuma 4 AM. Upazvura mvura kuseni na 5. Mvura yanga yakura yashoma. By then late morning vane pasina mvura.
Residents in Warren Park suburb complained that they only receive water at night.
Dambudziko ratinaro ndere mvura zvekuti mvura yacho kuya kwainoita inouya usiku kana usiku kuseni kuma 6-7 yapera toswera futi the whole day tisina mvura. Izvozvi ndiri kubva pana apa ndaenda kunochera mvura kuseri kweheroes ekako kuma stands ariko kuma bowls ariko kuti ndiwane mvura yekunwa nekubikisa nekugesa mira.
However, others have since dug wells in their yards to avert shortages.
Mvura yedu haiendi, tinoshandisa mvura zvakasasana zvekuti hatina dambudziko chero zvese zvatinoita toita nemvura yepabhoro.
Some residents lamented that if the water shortages persist, it may cause diseases.
Zvikaramba zvichiita saizvozvi zvika, tichapedzisira mune mutaa kuzeta manyoka. Kuuya kwemvura yacho dai kurunzi inozoya yakachena. Inotozopa paya paya ndopane zvinge yakachena. Asi nenyaya yekuti mumwe munhu anenge asina mvura yekunwa anogona kungonwa mvura iyoyo inenge njuva yakafanana iyo. Sangadai ichinzi mvura yedu ngaigare iripo all the time kwete zvekumboti inombonzi yambovharwa.
Korera ikadzoka hakuna unosara nokuti dambudziko racho kuti kana nyangwe matoireti tahwa tinoshaya kuti mvura yekudira matoireti teiwana kupi.
Meanwhile, Harare and Chitungwiza have been hit by a typhoid outbreak with at least 111 confirmed cases having been recorded on Wednesday. City officials attributed the outbreak to water shortages in the city and its satellite towns of Chitungwiza, Norton, Rua and Epworth. Reporting for ATV, I'm Jeffrey Moyo in Harare, Zimbabwe.
Medical experts say a healthy diet, exercise and early detection of breast cancer can save lives. Our reporter Eunice Ferrazai, who recently spoke to some cancer survivors, gives us the following report. This story contains graphic images.
Breast cancer is one of the leading killers in women in Zimbabwe, yet 80% of women in the country are not aware of the need for regular screening. A cancer specialist said early detection of cancer is the most successful way of treating the disease.
The earlier the breast cancer is detected, the more likely it is to survive it.
Some breast cancer survivors told ATV about their battle with the disease.
I had my first operation 22 years ago. I had radium treatment and I went on a tablet for a long, long time. I really don't know why I'm still here, but I'm still here. So there's hope for everybody, I feel.
I first discovered that I had cancer in 2006. But prior to that, I had had 4 lumpectomies. That means removal of lumps from the breast. And then the last lump, I thought it was benign as the others. And then when I went to have it removed, it was discovered that it had turned cancerous.
They said eating healthy foods is one of many ways of combating the disease.
You watch what you eat. You don't want to eat too many fats, too much sugar. Processed foods are not really good for you. But if you just eat good, healthy foods with lots of yellow and green vegetables,
Dr. Palescu concurred that a good diet would reduce the chances of the disease recurring.
Not to indulge in too much carbohydrates and fat, to have a healthy diet, to stick to your body weight. These are the best advice.
The survivors urged women to also conduct on checks of lumps in the breast, as this may help in the detection of cancer early.
Every month, once a month, sort of between your period, just when you're bathing or you're lying in bed, just lift your arms, and we call it walking our fingers around our breasts like this. You just go around like this, as you're watching me do now, and you feel. If there's a lump and it's still there the following month, then have something done about it.
At least 7,000 new cases of cancer are recorded every year in Zimbabwe, and nearly 60% of them are linked to HIV, while others are hereditary or caused by stress and unhealthy eating habits. Reporting for ATV in Bulawayo, Zimbabwe.
Despite the health risks associated with tenkenkau, an alcoholic beverage smuggled from Mozambique, some people in Bulawayo are not worried and have vowed to continue drinking. Eunice Feridai reports.
A potent alcoholic drink smuggled from neighboring Mozambique has now flooded the streets of Bulawayo, posing health risks to customers. The plastic packaged gin known as tekankao is gaining popularity in the city because it is cheaper than local brands. Some residents expressed concern over the potent cane spirit and urged police to intensify raids on the traders of the drink.
Tetangao is not good for people. Abantu bayinatha like by abuse yona. Abayinathi okuright. Sometimes abayidiluti and I think it's bad for abantu because sometimes they have a ginger the skin. Bayenza benza izinto ezibhedi eziviolent like owindi bemchova bayinatha. Sihamba bethethisa ama customer and at the end of the day cause ama accident.
Vanhu vazhinji tirikuona vachikuvara miri vachiti tirikunwa doro rakanaka because vari kuita abuse vari kunwa zvisirizvo saka ndokumbira kuti dai kambobhanwa mbichana kadoro aka.
Some traders defended the sale of the cane spirit and instead called for protection from police raids.
Mapurisa ari kudziringa zvekuti vari kutora imwe staff isingatsoki zvekuti ndo zvinodeita toambiri kudarika ipapo kuti vari kutivhiringa kuti vari kutora staff vachikona kutusa saka tachikumbira kuti taura nehome affairs kuti vatidzivire tsitsipanapo.
Cheap but potent alcoholic beverages have wreaked havoc in various parts of the country, causing blindness and in some cases death. Reporting for ATV in Bulawayo, Zimbabwe.
Former Highlanders coach Ali Baba Dube, affectionately known among the team's supporters as Baba Boso, has seen it all. He speaks about challenges facing Zimbabwean football and his days at Highlanders. Crispin Tabura reports.
Former Highlanders junior coach Ali Baba Dube has bemoaned the deterioration of soccer standards in the country and called on the implementation of the junior policy to improve the game. In a wide-ranging interview with ATV, Dube speaks about the challenges bedeviling the game of football and his heydays at Boso.
At Highlanders, Dube, popularly known as Baba Boso, was tasked to produce the best junior players for the team.
I'm a teacher.
but umfake ground practically. Ibhola practically, but theory yeah. But practically abakwanisi.
The 72-year-old who is now running a private restaurant still boasts of having produced some of the best players at Boso.
Abantu babethanda kakhulu team lelo yoke ko Willard ogodfrey Parasa labo super nesayo. Ngokuma Julia zonke ngihamba kusiza njenge stage by stage because kugcina sokubuya igeng yabo Adam. Adam badlala labo kwenje kwaso sokubuya uPeter Ndlovu labo uBenjamin Konje.
One of Highlanders fans commended Baba Boso for the job well done during his career spanning 37 years.
Since Nkalo Kumazi, I think it's a great achievement for Highlanders. I can say it's a great coach.
Dube dismissed claims of using juju to win matches as cheap.
Yeah, we feel that we have been last skill, been a last support. The coach is going to be a good coach. Okay, meet the local. This guy can't go to the team. It's been a long time.
Ali Baba Dube, who groomed prominent players such as Peter Ndlovu, Willard Kumalo, and Namu Shambira, still remains in the hearts of many Boso lovers. Reporting for ATV, I'm Chris Pentavra in Bulawayo, Zimbabwe.
Thank you for joining us. Good night.